Okay. Well, thanks everybody. Thanks for joining the webinar today. So my name is Kyle Mestre. I'm the PTL for the networking project in OpenStack, otherwise known as Neutron. I've got my Twitter handle and my IRC handle down there if you need to get a hold of me. And so let's go and we'll talk about what's up in networking for Liberty. So before we jump into what we're doing, I find it's always good to kind of level set what exactly the networking project in OpenStack is doing. And so the mission statement, as defined in the governance docs for this, is to implement services and associated libraries to provide on-demand, scalable, and technology-agnostic network abstraction. And I think one thing that you're going to notice both in some of the work we've done in Kilo and definitely what we're doing in Liberty is we're definitely going down that path. So let's take a quick peek back at Kilo as far as Neutron is concerned and see what we did. So these are just the statistics, the raw statistics from Launchpad for what we actually completed in Kilo. So you can see we completed 45 blueprints and we closed 544 bugs as well. Those are pretty good numbers and they're pretty much in line with what we did in the Juno release as well. One of the big things that we did in Kilo, which actually we're already seeing the benefits of as far as velocity of development, is the advanced services split. So we split out the advanced services, which include firewall, load balancer, and VPN, into separate Git repositories. And they actually release as their own tarball now. They still are aligned with the main Neutron release, and they still require the Neutron server to run, but it's possible in a future release that these advanced services, either some or all of them, will end up with their own API endpoints as well. And the other big effort we did was we started this plugin decomposition effort in Neutron. When we ended Kilo, we had over 50 plugins and drivers, and at this point, we started kind of decomposing some of the back ends of them. That was the first part of this. So we had 10 or more of these that started this decomposition effort. And again, this was all about increasing feature velocity and review velocity on both sides. So as we look at Liberty, what Neutron is gonna be looking at for Liberty, we're gonna definitely continue with this phase two of the plugin decomposition. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in a future slide. But that is one item where the core of your team is focused on trying to complete that, completing the mission and the vision that we had when we started that in Kilo. As part of that, the plan is also to decompose the reference plugin, which is ML2 and the OVS Linux Bridge Agent. We'll get that decomposed. We've also started working on API microversioning and increasing our quota support as well at this point. So let's start talking about some of the things that we're doing in Liberty now. With regards to Neutron and Nova Network, so I think as most folks are aware, when Neutron was originally spun up, it was actually known as Quantum, and it did not start from the Nova Network code base. It actually started from a fresh code base, and it started with a different API as well. So now, 3-4 years down the road, we're getting close to the point where I think everyone knows that we'd like to have one networking stack, and we've been working hard for over a year as far as ensuring we cover all of the use cases of Nova Network. We've been looking at migration options and things like that. So let's see where we're at in Liberty now. I think most people know that in Ice House is where we started to set the groundwork for achieving this, and during Juno and Kilo, the team worked really hard on closing the functionality gap, especially with things like DVR. So during Liberty, the focus around Neutron and Nova Network is going to be on the following items. One of the things that came out of the Ops Meetup and in Vancouver was the fact that a lot of the existing people that are using Nova Network are using Linux Bridge. We have Linux Bridge support. It's just that it was not tested in the gates. We have some people who are working on enabling that now so that we can ensure that that support is tested as well as the Open vSwitch agent is at this point. We also have some work on a specification that we've kind of colloquially called Get Me a Network. So this specification is specifically around providing a kind of a simple wrapper API for Neutron, where you can effectively say, get me a network, and it will utilize pre-existing Neutron resources or create the resources and return them. And so this would be things like, you know, when you would like to boot a VM, you need to have a network, you need to have a subnet, and then you have a port on that in Neutron as well. And then if you want external connectivity, you need a router for that as well. So this would be about simplifying that for this type of use case. You would obviously still, the API would still remain as it is, so those people that are using it to build rich network topologies, you'll obviously still be able to do that as well. And I think another item that came up during the Vancouver summit when we were talking with operators was we're going to do a much better job of documenting shared provider networks, because this is the mode and the operational mode you deploy Neutron in that maps closest to Nova Network, and especially to Nova Network installs of nodes where people are doing it at any sort of scale. So we support this, and we have for a while. It's just that I think we're doing a better job of trying to document this at this point. So the next item I wanted to bring up was what we've kind of termed the Neutron Stadium. So as most people are aware, OpenStack has undergone some big governance changes, which has been termed the big tent. So Neutron has actually also changed along with this governance model as well, and we've kind of termed ours the Neutron Stadium. We didn't want to steal the big tent acronym from the broader OpenStack project. And what this effectively means is, you know, we're allowing many more Git repositories into the networking project, into the Neutron Stadium, starting in Liberty now. And initially what we've seen is a lot of just plugins and drivers that decomposed and moved a lot of their backend code out into StackForge. Most of those have proposed themselves and have been moved back under the OpenStack namespace, under the Neutron program as well. We've also seen some potential new APIs that have done this as well, where they've started off on StackForge, and now they're coming back. The prime example of that is the L2 gateway work, which handles translating typically between an overlay network like VXLAN or GRE into a VLAN network that physical devices can understand. And then another example is, you know, we have a service function chaining project that started now as a separate Git repository, where a bunch of interested parties are all working together to come up with an SFC API for Neutron as well. And really, this is all about continuing to grow kind of the ecosystem under Neutron as a platform for networking and OpenStack. So some other governance changes that we had in detail. One of the things that we wanted to do was we wanted to continue trying to scale core reviewers inside of Neutron. And one of the problems that we've had is, you know, Neutron is a fairly large project at this point that composes a lot of different things, and it's incredibly hard for people to kind of grasp all the different pieces in any level of detail. So we ended up with a lot of people that are specialists in certain different areas. So we've kind of changed the model of this, and we have this new lieutenant model, which will hopefully allow us to scale core reviewers. So we still have the PTL, which is myself, and then we have 7 lieutenants for different areas underneath, for things like the reference implementation, API and database, testing, and other areas like that. And then what we've done is we've actually allowed the lieutenants to propose new core reviewers for their area so that we can add additional core reviewers. And so far we've had 4 new core reviewers proposed in specific areas, and so far this is actually working out really well. It's really trying to scale the development and the leadership of the project, kind of similar to how the Linux kernel scales itself with kind of a pyramid structure as well. And then the other big item we did was around specs as well. You know, we had a specs repository for the last 2 cycles where people would submit specifications, everyone would review them and things like that. And it turns out that for us at least, what we typically saw happening was the specs repository became a pipe, and it ended up just another pipe that got filled with things. And so initially, it was great, but then once the pipe got full, we were just left with a lot of things clogged up on the back end there as well. So what we did was we defined this new process which we call RFE, or Request for Enhancement, and it basically allows us to streamline the way that work is proposed into Neutron. So the new process indicates that you file a bug with your feature, and you indicate, you know, the what you would like, not the how it's going to be implemented. We file the RFE bugs. Everyone is encouraged to review these. The Neutron drivers team will review these as well and move them into a confirmed and triage state as they're looked at. And then once we've all agreed that yes, this work is relevant, and we've talked to lieutenants who are actually mostly supposed to be assigning the work to the people that work underneath them, we'll move the bug in, and then we still expect some sort of documentation. But the idea is, when you're implementing it, the documentation becomes part of the developer documentation and merges with the code as well. So far this is proven to be pretty useful. We'll obviously have a lot more information on how this has worked out once Liberty is done. I'll really quickly run through decomposition phase two. So this again completed phase one during Hilo. Phase two is effectively going to allow all third-party code to be removed from the main Neutron repository. You know, we're basically dealing with things like database migrations at this time, which were still left in tree, and the shim plugin as well. And the goal is to split all of that out. The reference implementation will also be split out. The advanced services are starting to decompose some of their backend drivers. The nice thing about the advanced services was people who were proposing new ones saw the benefit of plugin decomposition on the drivers and plugins for the core Neutron resources, so some of the new services things were actually decomposed from the start as well. So this has worked out pretty well for us as well. So we're continuing. So one of the other feature items we're working on is we're continuing a bunch of work around our REST RPC and plugin layers as well. We actually have a feature branch which is looking to move us from our homegrown WSGI layer into using the Pecan library. So that work is actually ongoing right now. It's going pretty good, so we're hopeful to move that before Liberty 2. We have some API microversioning work that is being done at this point as well, which I think is going to benefit a lot of people. And then we also have, you know, we've done a lot of work around RPC versioning in Kilo, and now we're adding some support for upgrade checking to ensure that actually stays consistent at this point as well. So, quality of service in QoS. This was a big feature that has been talked about for probably a year and a half in Neutron. But this time, we've actually set up kind of a sub-team to actually focus on working on this. The good news is, the QoS sub-team is actually, this week, the first week of July, is actually having a mid-cycle where they're actually focused and heads down writing code for QoS at this point. So the Liberty focus for QoS is going to be around bandwidth limiting. And we're also going to make sure we lay out the QoS models for the future so that we can add and extend the API and the models to introduce additional QoS concepts that a lot of people have been interested in. We decided to focus on bandwidth initially so that we could actually deliver something in the Liberty timeframe and then allow things to kind of be set up for future additions to this during the next cycle as well. And currently, we're targeting QoS policies either per port or per network. So another feature we're looking at is role-based access control for networks. This is actually a really huge feature that we believe as well, because currently our shared network concept is not granular. We have the concept of a shared network, but it's all or nothing at this point. So this is actually going to allow tenants to create and share network resources with other tenants if they want. That's one use case that has been bandied about and that people have been interested in. And then the other one is this will allow an operator to define networks as well, and it will allow them to limit access as well. So right now, an operator can define a shared network, but it's shared between all tenants, so this would allow them to create maybe tiers of shared networks. So I think this will be a useful thing for operators to have as well. So we'll talk about IPAM. So those of you who were at who attended my Kilo webinar will know that this was an item for Kilo, and We didn't get this merge near the end of Hilo for a variety of reasons. The good news is we've already started merging the patches for this into Liberty, and this will be a part of Liberty as well. This has been a really requested feature by operators who are already utilizing an existing IP address management system and would like to integrate it with their OpenStack cloud with Neutron. So that's exactly what this will allow you to do. This will be a nice feature for operators, I think. So address scopes, BGP, and routed networks. This is a lot of stuff, and you know, I threw this on here because I think this is important both from an operator perspective, but mostly from an operator perspective. So in Hilo, we had the concept of subnet pools that we added. And this allowed an operator or a user to create a pool of IP addresses. And then when they were booting a VM, they would not have to specify specific IP addresses or anything. They could just specify the pool, and the code would allocate addresses from there. You could even allocate actual subnets. So when you created a subnet, you could allocate that from the subnet pool. So this work kind of continues expanding upon that a little bit as well. So this is going to allow us to continue evolving network routing in Neutron. So BGP, this will allow us to advertise Neutron routes externally into an existing operator's network. So this work is ongoing right now. Address scopes, this work is also ongoing and will allow us these address scopes to be first-class citizens of the Neutron API. And then routed networks, the original goal was to allow a router to connect to a network without consuming IP addresses. Turns out that this work also allows us to satisfy some use cases around things like L3-only networks and network segments, which a lot of operators have been interested in. So there's been a lot of discussion on this, these topics, and I think these will be pretty useful to operators. So flavor framework, this is something that we started working on during Hilo, and we're hopeful to merge this in Liberty as well because the patches are out and everything's been approved. So this is going to be great for operators because it's going to be a way for them to offer network services to their clients at different levels. But you can it also allows us to separate the driver functionality and the configuration from the consumers of these services. So an example of how this would work would be if you as an operator have a cloud where you have deploying something like load balancing. And so you're offering load balancing to your tenants. Let's say that you have some really fancy hardware load balancers from a place maybe like A10 networks or F5 networks, and then you can offer those to your tenants. But then let's say you only have a few of those and you have a lot of tenants. You may also want to offer software-based HA proxy routers or something like using Octavia, which also uses HA proxy. So a flavor framework would allow you to assign kind of classes of service to those. So you could assign your fancy A10 and F5 load balancers. You could assign those a gold level of service. And you could maybe assign the HA proxy one a bronze level. And maybe Octavia, which is kind of a service VM-based load balancer, give that like a silver level. So this would allow all of your tenants to be able to select their functionality based on this flavor. And it allows you as the operator to expose these that way to your tenants. And likely you may end up charging your tenants based on the level of service they pick and things like that. So it really is a nice thing for operators, and we're pretty excited to be offering this as well. So NFV work, we're continuing to work on NFV, network function virtualization stuff. There is still a sub-team that's working on this in OpenStack. Some of the things we're working on in this area in the Liberty timeframe include are seamlessly connecting hardware and Neutron L2 segments. There's some work going on with Ironic, which is the bare metal provisioning platform, or bare metal driver. And so that we're actually working closely with the Ironic team on that. We have some work around unaddressed ports. So this would allow you to have a port without an L3 address or subnet. This has been important from an NFV perspective as well. And of course, we approved the spec for trunk ports to virtual machines, which is pretty critical to the NFV work. It's been a requested feature for a while. So load balancer work. The load balancer team has really picked up steam, and they're doing a lot of interesting work during the Liberty cycle as well. So they're going to add support for layer 7 switching, which is typically known as content-based routing. They're also going to move to Octavia as the default reference implementation for LDAP. So Octavia is a service VM-based LDAP that uses DT proxy underneath. So, this is where, you know, they're making a lot of work and they're doing a lot of things to make LDAPs pretty great. I suspect that they, at some point, either in Liberty or the M cycle, they'll end up with a separate load balancer API endpoint as well. So, just a quick list of what plugins are proposed here. We have some new plugins and drivers proposed. We have the Dragonflow L3 DVR plugin, which was proposed as a separate repository and has come in as well. It implements L3 routing and it implements the DVR functionality as well. InfoBlox has their IPAM and DHCP plugin, so they're going to work as an upstream once the IPAM work goes up. Cat Technologies has proposed an LBAS driver for V2. We have some folks who have proposed LibreSwan as a VPN driver. And then, of course, we have the Octavia LDAS V2 driver as well. And so, at this point of the cycle, we actually have one plugin that's disappearing. So the Meta plugin is going to be deprecated. I don't believe that anyone other than NTT was using the Meta plugin, and they were maintaining it. So they've chosen to deprecate it at this point. So it's the only thing we have disappearing at this point. And so I think that's it for the updates from Neutron at this point. I'd just like to say if you have any questions or anything around the development aspects, feel free to send an email to the OpenStack Dev List and make sure you tag it in the subject as with Neutron. And then also we have an IRC channel, OpenStack Neutron, where a bunch of the community congregates there. So feel free to drop in there with any questions as well. So thanks for taking the time. I'm happy to present on this.